Yeah, cool. Cool. Yeah, hello everyone. I'm here with Josh, our head of tech evangelism. Hey, Josh.
Hello.
And I'm Zoe, VP of Growth at Phala Network. And we want to give you a short teaser of content and what to expect or what you can expect at East Denver, because the Phala team will be in Denver starting from the 23rd of February to the 3rd of March. And we have a packed schedule with very cool events. And Josh will give you some insights what you guys can expect. So overall, Josh, what it's our third time, I think, that we are going to Denver. What are you most excited about to go to Denver and to join East Denver Conference?
Yeah, so since it's like my third conference at East Denver, I'm really excited to see like what the new trends are and what the Web3 developers are building on currently. Like from my like current understanding of the market at home, and being able to like tinker around with other protocols, I've seen a major growth in Web3 social, and seeing developers build on protocols like Farcaster with the new implementation with frames, and then Lens with open actions and their frame derivative, what called portals on a.xyz. I really find these like technologies most exciting because it's starting to break down that barrier between Web3 and Web2. And now we're starting to witness a new wave of dApps that are coming with a familiar Web2 interface with the Web3 native backend. And that's what I'm most excited about.
Cool. Yeah, I guess we have a lot of content also and cool workshop content ready for these topics and trends that you just described. So besides Josh and myself, we also have our two co-founders, Marvin as well as Hang, joining to the conference, as well as our COO and head of compute, Doily. So we have a big team representing Phala. So very excited to have you guys also join all these events. And as I mentioned, Josh would also be there during the Builder Week to inspire some of you guys to join our official bounty. And on the 27th of February, we start also with our Hacker House, the Multiprover Hack Day, in cooperation with the Graph, Automata, and Flashbots. And Josh, you're going to give also a workshop. What can people expect from this Hack Day and the live workshops that you are going to present?
Yeah, so this from our Hack Day and live workshop that we'll be presenting, first is going to be preempted by the Graph having their presentation and their workshop building a subgraph with Scaffold ETH2. And Scaffold ETH is a really nice, familiar development front end for Web3 developers in general. So a lot of EVM developers will be familiar with this. So after they get the information from Kevin, who will be presenting this workshop from the Graph, I will then come in next with the Graph Starter Kit, utilizing Scaffold ETH as well. And then we'll kind of take the knowledge that you learn from the Graph workshop, and then take that and learn how to add some off-chain compute via the Graph Starter Kit with Phala Network in general. So this workshop will help you build more like data-driven dApps that we're not really seeing out today. And from my perspective, I think it'll be a lot more fun for the developers to follow along, and it'll be very easy to follow along because we're making it very simple, and you'll have like a nice little visual of exactly what's going on during the workshop.
Cool. That's great to hear. Yeah, we put a lot of effort in like the user onboarding journey, right? Like to make it very simple to use our templates. I'm personally also very excited for this workshop. So yeah, let's all everyone to join us on the 27th. We dropped the link also below to join this event. This week, again, will be very packed. We then are also joining the real world event, the Deepin event by IoTX. It's happening on the 28th. And we have Marvin and both of our co-founders joining and speaking this event. So please see us there. And on the 28th, we also have a mini summit that's representing the whole or a lot of ecosystem teams from the Polkadot ecosystem. So you can also see our co-founders speaking there. Another event that I'm also very excited about is Beyond ZK. We are hosting this one in cooperation with Oasis and Secret Network on the 29th. So if you are interested in other technologies such as TE, definitely come and join us there. And maybe also another question to you, Josh. We see that TEs was criticized quite a lot in the last year in the crypto world. Why do you think it's very important to educate about TEs in Web3?
Oh, I think it's very important to educate all Web3 developers in general and other ZK solutions on the value proposition that TEs provide as a coprocessor for blockchain applications. We're starting to see more protocols integrate or partner with existing TEE solutions. And this is like very exciting because as the market is starting to heat up, I believe it is very important to understand the benefits that TEs have and how they can offer more flexibility and more versatility for the dApps that are being built today. So I'm really excited to be at this summit and then also hear all the experts in the TEE space and then also like in ZK and FHE as well, just to understand where they're thinking and where this market is heading as it's starting to heat up.
Amazing. Yeah, also definitely a topic that will be discussed a lot, as you mentioned, also besides other technologies or trends that were already discussed more in the last years, but TEs is definitely a topic that also is very important part in the DeepIn space for this year. So join us on these events. I just mentioned that we also have a DeepIn mega event called Agents Unleashed in cooperation with OLAS that's happening on the 3rd of March. The 1st of March, sorry. And then we have 2nd of March, our third edition of Infra Garden. So all of these events, we are really discussing the importance of specific types of infrastructure in Web3. So Infra Garden is also a beautiful event, which we are hosting for the third time in cooperation with Diadata, IDOS, and Subsquid. And of course, we also have a booth. So on the 29th, you can find us in the Sports Castle at the Phala booth. Maybe some insights, Josh, what can people discuss with us at the booth? Any specific product updates that we are going to showcase or present?
Oh yeah, from a products perspective, I would say one of the newly released products that we have recently launched is a Farcaster frame template called the Frame Hub template. And this is the ability for you to host your frames on Phala Network as the backend. So you can ditch for sell and you can start to use Frame Hub as your one-stop shop to building your frames and then utilizing the flexibility and the versatility of Phala Network to host the backend. So this is one of the new products that I'm very excited about. And then we also have some new back contract like 2.0 templates that have come out, which would be the Graph Starter Kit, which we've mentioned earlier with the workshop that's gonna accompany that. And then the AirStack starter kit as well, which you'll have access to AirStack's robust API and being able to bring that data on chain. And then lastly, we also have a new VRF template that I've personally used and built a product with already. So I'm really excited for these new products to be out there and then showcase them to all the curious developers learning to learn more about Phala.
Amazing. There's a lot in store that we can present during this, during the booth time or at the booth, but also during the side events. I think it's pretty clear why developers should join our side events, right? To learn about all of these new updates and to get hands on and also, of course, ask the question because we are joined by you as the lead of tech evangelism. We also have our CTO and CEO there. So a great team to ask any questions. And lastly, we are also putting up a bounty at the official Buildathon hackathon, so to say. So are there any suggestions, Josh, when people want to build on or want to hack on our bounty, what you would suggest, any ideas or use cases they could come up with?
Yeah, so the Buildathon bounty will be involving the Frame Hub template that I just mentioned, which is building a Farcaster frame. So one of the things you first want to do is sign up for a Farcaster account through Warpcast, and then check out our Frame Hub template on GitHub just to see how to get started and deploy a quick frame right away. And then from there, when it comes to some use cases, I would suggest looking into AirStack's API to see like their on-chain kit that they have built for specifically for Farcaster frames and figure out how to combine all these all this information that they've indexed on and off chain, so that you can create some like really interesting use cases. So like, for instance, some use cases that I could see being really interesting are some social gaming apps, something like a Tamagotchi, Farmville, and maybe like Minesweeper. Then another frame could be something about like your social profile, being able to generate a frame based on the user that interacts with it, and it generates all the statistics about this user's on-chain and off-chain data from AirStack, so that you can have like a cool little frame that's specific to the user. Another is gated frames, and many other use cases where you start to get a little more creative and start to build out kind of whatever you would like to see on a like Web3 social app in this case. So developers are required, whenever they do their submission, to open source their repos and then also publish their frames on WordCast for us to judge and interact with. So I'm really excited to see like what people build, and I'm more than willing to help out anybody that is having a try with our bounty, and I can help you, and you can reach out to me directly whenever you'd like.
Amazing. Yes, definitely. You're very supportive in all of our hackathons. So Josh, we'll be there to support any ideas. And if you guys want to reach us, we have a Telegram group, a public chat that we are also linking here below, where we will be posting our schedule and all of the side events that we are involved in, because it will be a busy week, but we are very excited to meet a lot of you guys there to connect and network. Cool. Thank you, everyone, and see you in Denver.
Bye-bye.
Cool. And then just...